Hey everyone, this is Jonathan from HealthyPlace's mental illness and relationships blog. I'm here in Glacier National Park in Montana on an absolutely beautiful day. What we're going to talk about today is the ability to have a thriving social existence without having a successful romantic life. As I mentioned in this blog post, dating and I have not had the best of relationships recently. Part of that is due to my illness, and part of it is due to me being picky, and you know, all sorts of other factors that we don't need to get into. But I'm here in the park with two of my best friends and their kids. And really the important thing when traveling, when just being with other people, especially when you get to be, I'm 37 now, most of my friends are married, most of them have kids, is just to not let yourself feel like a third wheel if you don't want to be. Make sure that you're carving out your own spot within a group, and that you really allow yourself to be social. I find that it's been very limiting if I've ever said, you know, the only people I should hang out with are other people who are single, or I should just be by myself. And even though I enjoy my alone time, there's something really great and really nice about being in a group of people. So I'm here with some amazing friends. They're right back there. One of their kids is being sworn in for the Junior Ranger program here, which is adorable. And I hope that you guys, even if sometimes dating can be pretty hard, still manage to put a good positive social life together. It's really important.